CUKTECH is one of the rising stars of high-performance power banks and chargers. We've taken apart its No. 20 and No. 30 power bank. Those models can support PD 3.1, but may be a little bit pricey for some people. Today, we're going to take apart a more affordable option, the No. 15 power bank. Flip to the back, all specs info are here. We'll talk about it later. Open the box and take out the power bank. It also comes with a dual USB-C cable with a length of 1 meter. The ChargeLab Power ZKM003C shows it supports USB PD 3.1, and the charging speed can be up to 240 watts. There is a small display in the upper left corner, which indicates the remaining battery. The 150 watts max design on the power button highlights the most critical feature. Then let me introduce the detailed specs info. Model is PB200P. The battery capacity is 20,000 mAh, and the energy is about 73 watt-hours. The USB-C one can support up to 90 watts input power, and it can output up to 120 watts when using a dedicated 6M cable and supported devices. These small Y bumps and grooves on the rubber pad at the button can increase the friction, so you can hold it more tightly. Since the maximum energy does not exceed 100 watt-hours, there is no problem taking it with you on the plane. The upper panel is on the top. There are two USB-C and a USB-A ports. Only the USB-C one supports input and output at the same time. The size of this power bank is about 163x57x40mm, and the weight is about 452 grams. The ChargeLab Power ZKM003C shows the USB-C one supports PD 3.0, PBS, QC5, and DCP protocols. It also has 5 fixed speeds of 5V, 9V, 12V, 15V, 3A, 20V, 5A, and 2 sets of BBS. The USB-C 2 also supports PD 3.0, PBS, QC4, and DCP protocols, but the power jumps from 100 watts to 30 watts. It has 3 fixed speeds of 5V, 9V, 3A, 12V, 2.5A, and a set of BBS. Finally, the USB-A supports UFCS, QC 3.0, and DCP protocols. After introducing the basic info, let's pry along the gap to remove the rubber pad at the bottom. As we can see, there are some silicon adhesives pasted on the battery cells. 4 battery cells are connected in series, and the capacity of a single battery cell is 5,000 mAh. 2 thermistors are pasted under the heat-resistant tape for temperature detection. Continue to remove fixing screws. And separate the internal module. The PCB is covered with a layer of black shielding. The main PCB is on the other side of the power bank. The blue, red, and black wires for voltage sampling are used to detect 3 different places of 4 battery cells. Take a closer look at the 21700 battery cells. They are from EVE, and the capacity is 5 amp hour for each one. Then let's remove all fixing screws. And separate battery cells and PCB. The main PCB is placed on an aluminum plate and fixed with a plastic frame. Those thermal pads on the aluminum plate and exposed copper on the back of the PCB can greatly enhance its heat dissipation performance. The nickel strips of battery cells are directly spot welded to the PCBA module. almost all components are on the front of the PCB. Let's introduce them one by one. Start from the circuit of USB-C 1. The buck boost controller of USB-C 1 is from Southchip and is used to control DC input and USB-C output. It integrates the I2C protocol, which can control current limits, reverse discharge, etc. The largest buck boost inductor is wound with three wires in parallel and is insulated with heat shrinkable tubing. Those four synchronous buck boost MOSFETs of the USB-C 1 are from AOS and adopt DFN 5x6 package, 30V, 2.75 mΩ. Two blue solid capacitors for upper filtering of USB-C 1 are from CapXon PM series. They are connected in parallel and fixed with glue, 100 microfarad, 25 volts for each. A discharge resistor is soldered between two capacitors. Two ABOV bus MOSFETs of USB-C 1 are from Toshiba. Another discharge resistor is used for the output of USB-C 1, 510 ohm. Then move to the circuits of USB-C 2 and USB-A. The buck boost converter is also from Southchip and adopts QFN 4x4 package. It integrates four MOSFETs and has multiple protection functions. A 2.2 microhenry alloy inductor is next to the converter. Those two Apple VBUS MOSFETs of USB-C 2 are from Toshiba. Another discharge resistor is used for the output of USB-C 2, 510 ohm. Here is the controller of switching circuit for USB-A. The MCU is from ABOV and integrates 8051 core. It can be regarded as a protocol chip, and it supports PD3.1 and a wide range of other fast charging protocols. The segment LED display and power button are reinforced with a plastic frame. Take a closer look at the button. The LED driver IC is from Titan Micro. It supports 16x8 LED and can adjust the display brightness via duty cycle. This tiny buck chip that powers the MCU is marked with HMEOD. A 4.7 microhenry inductor is next to it. Another buck chip is marked with LUFAA. The voltage regulator is marked with L4JNK. The battery protection chip is from ICM. It supports lithium iron phosphate batteries and integrates high precision voltage current detection circuits. Two protection MOSFETs for battery cells are from AOS and adopt DFN 5x6 package, 30 volts, 1.4 mΩ. The color of USB-C 1 is different from USB-C 2. You can distinguish them more intuitively. And the USB-A is soldered on the hollow of the PCB to reduce thickness. Well, that's all components of the CUKTECH 150W power bank. As an affordable option, it does not support USB PD 3.1, but the PD output power of USB-C 1 can still reach 100W. Even though performance is compromised, its quality does not. It integrates four battery cells and two independent buck boost circuits. The all-black PCB and thick aluminum plate make it more solid. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can click the corners to check teardown videos of CUKTECH No.20 and No.30 power banks. Then choose the one that suits you best. See you in the next video. Bye!